Meve arrived at the walls of Gradobor, famed for fine rugs and woven tapestries. The city's artisans had been at work, no doubt pressed by the Nilfgaardians, for atop the tallest spire, that of the town hall, flapped a lustrous ebony flag, a sun of golden threads at its center. So vast was the banner, Gascon whistled in admiration.
Got to admit, the black clad certainly have panache.
And a vast and powerful army, I'd remind you.
Reynard interjected.
Arbalists line the walls. That stench in the air, hot tar. And our scouts claim the black clad stand armed to the hilt with the best Mahakam has to offer. Victory's not likely to come cheap, I fear.
No cost is too high,
said Meave, a hardness in her voice.
Reynard, Gascon, ready our men to attack.
The Lyrians needed no more encouragement. Since arriving, they had reveled in anticipation of taking the city, then ripping the banner from its spire.
It will be difficult, Your Grace. The walls are strong.
Someone's opening the gate! Forward, march!
In retreat!
Hey, don't toss that. It's perfectly usable. Wise choice.
I smell a leak.
Go on, Enkazel!
bigger they are, easier they are to target.
Discipline. That is what you folk lack.
Thing about slings, they hide well. Ever have a stone knock out one of your teeth? I've hit the white of an eye from half a league away.
There's a time to reap, a time to sow, and a time to die.
This is a Zweifel!
Roto dum anime est, des est.
El Herta.
Victory, Your Grace! The city is ours!
The battle for Gradobor was a hard fight, though not quite as hard as most had thought it might be. During the assault, at its critical juncture, a blow fell from the blue. The unlikely heroes, merchants and burghers brought together by the city's guilds, a wave of them, all riled, swarmed the black-clads at the gates and opened them wide to let Lyria in.
Onward! Follow me!
As fighting died down around the city, Meave rode for the town hall on a personal quest. Nilfgaard's vast, garish banner rippled overhead. With its halyard cut, it plunged like a great black bird, stricken. It was the last any would see of the golden sun over Gradobor.
Three cheers! Hip, hip,
hooray!
The Lyrians were victorious, though not without aid. Meave met with the merchants who had roused the townsfolk, inspired them to rise up and fight.
Many of my soldiers, dozens, perhaps hundreds, owe you their lives today,
said the Queen.
For that, I am deeply grateful. No, deeply indebted. Should you know a way I might repay the debt, don't for a moment hesitate to ask.
The merchants exchanged glances, nodded, grunted, agreed with each other without uttering a word. Then one, a cloth fuller, his moustache most robust, stepped forth, bowed low, and spoke for them all.
Your Majesty, the invaders brought laws. Laws what don't agree with customs we've long held. Non-humans they forced us to accept. Let them join our guilds, sit on the city council. It's right ridiculous it is. These treacherous dwarves, why, they've been on their side from the start, so it's no wonder. But, well, the Nilfgaardian reforms, we'd like you to revoke them. Non-humans must know their place.
An awkward silence ensued. All turned their eyes to the Queen, awaiting her response.
I agree. Non-humans must know their place,
began the Queen.
So listen closely, all. Whether elf, dwarf, gnome, or human, it matters not. My subjects are equal.
Your Grace, you said it thyself. Were it not for us,
my troops would have died, true. Yet among the dead, there'd have been dwarves of Mahakam, I've no doubt. Dwarves who agreed to fight by my side when none believed I could prevail.
The tradesman huffed, the tradesman puffed. Meave silenced them with a firm swipe of her hand. She left Gradobor that very day, furious at the city's merchants for their bigotry, and irked at an unpleasant truth. That even the vile Nilfgaardians occasionally got something right. Come nightfall, the Lyrians pitched camp. Meave sat down and stared into the fire. Her officers, advisors, kept their distance, unsure if her eyes burned with the fire's reflection or a fury deep inside. Only Gabor dared approach her.
You can. Not lying back, I asked myself. Gabor, ya bampot, you gone bar me? Left my home, clan, family. And for why? To follow a human queen. But the day you showed me, I made the right choice.
Gabor stood and went back to the mess tent. Had he lingered a bit longer, he'd have seen Meave smile.
Well, our very own queen on the dwarf elders.
Beautifully knocked those racist knoblickers down a peg. Hear, hear, dear queen. Beautifully.
Well, well. Our very own queen on the dwarf elder's leash. Why am I not surprised? Well.
Thank you.
Have it the white of an eye from half a league away.
Left, right, left, right.
Ha! 152, 154.
Quick and painful this'll be.
Bigger they are, easier they are to tap. Ever have a stone knock out one of your teeth?
Grabbing duty again? Oh, gods!
Stop your yapping and start digging.
For the Queen!
New orders? No?
May the scrious ends here! Time I wiped it away!
God save the Queen!
Again and again and again.
Yes?
Ah.
Thank you.
Ah.
Cursed traitors.
Go on, Enkazel!
I think you'll really like this one.
That is what you folk lack.
There's been a mistake. I'm no mage.
I live to serve you.
I'll manage. Catch you in a full week.
Try to win them all, but you won't.
Take anymore.
hunger and suffering. For what?